Hello, anatomy colleagues, and welcome to the last lecture video for the musculoskeletal portion of the course. And we are going to discuss the muscles of the foot. We will find some similarities to what we saw in the hand. We will have lumbricals and interossei kind of bouncing back. But I want to start with some fascia that's actually located in this region, because really the major role of the foot muscles and the fascia in this region are protection and to support all that weight of the body. And because of that, we have a fairly robust region on the plantar surface, or the sole of the foot region, of fascia. So plantar fascia is just the deep fascia of the foot. And it's going to have this really thick central part that you can see right here. And this is often referred to as plantar aponeurosis. The more medial and lateral portions of the plantar fascia, they're robust, but not nearly as robust as what you have in the central part. And what you're going to see are these really longitudinally arranged bundles of dense fibrous connective tissue. And really, this fascia is holding the parts of the foot together. It is going to function as a superficial ligament. It will protect the sole from injury, and it will importantly help support the longitudinal arches of the foot. You can see it extending from the calcaneus, and then there will be these small kind of digital slips of plantar aponeurosis that will extend up to the digits. Now, if you have a tearing or kind of inflammation in this region that is referred to as plantar fasciitis, oftentimes plantar fasciitis can just be relieved by not using that area quite as much, kind of keeping off that region. But in certain cases, sometimes you'll have to have some type of surgical intervention to correct that. Now, of the 20 intrinsic muscles of the foot, meaning that they have both their proximal and distal attachments on the foot region, 14 of those muscles are going to be located on the plantar side, 2 are on the dorsal side, and 4 are kind of intermediate. And despite these being separated, particularly on the plantar side, despite these being separated into compartments, they're really playing small synergistic roles in other actions. And their primary function is going to be to work as a group during the support phase of stance, so really maintaining those arches of the foot. And really, there's less importance for these muscles of the foot in their individual actions, as fine control of the individual toes is not as important for most people as what we had in the hand. So we're going to kind of talk big picture things with these muscles, and less about each individual muscle, like we did with the hand region. So when we're talking about the plantar side, the majority of these will play some role in terms of flexion of the digits, particularly when we're talking about flexor hallucis brevis, flexor digiti minimi brevis. You will even have a flexor digitorum brevis. And then you will have some muscles that will play a role in terms of abduction and adduction in these regions right here. You do have lumbricals and interossei associated with the foot, like we had with the hand. The lumbricals are going to have, similar to what we had in the hand, a proximal attachment on tendons. And specifically, it will be the flexor digitorum longus tendons. And then you will have them inserting into the extensor expansions. So these will flex the metatarsophalangeal, or MP, joints, and then extend the toes, or those interphalangeal joints, of 2 through 5. So the reason it's crossing right here, it can play a role with flexion, but then the fact that they are attaching on the extensor expansions mean that they can extend the toes. We have both dorsal and plantar, not palmar, but plantar interossei when we're talking about the foot. It shares the similar actions with the lumbricals, with flexion of those MP joints and extension of the toes. But similar to what we had in the hand, they will also play a role in terms of abduction and adduction. And when we're talking about which digit from which the other digits are abducting or adducting, It is the second digit, not the third, like we had in the hand. So those dorsal interossei will abduct, so move away from the second digit. Whereas the, and I have palmar here. Oh my goodness, I totally messed up right at the end. Dang. Plantar. So those plantar interossei will adduct or move towards the second digit. Now the reason that we don't have an interossei right here on the first digit is that it is going to have its own individual muscle that will play a role in terms of adduction. So it's really going to only, you only have the plantar interossei on digits 3 through 5. And those would adduct or move towards the second digit. Okay, so hopefully this is a review because we have similar actions in the hand and the feet. But when we're talking about lumbricals and interossei, we know that they share two sets of actions in common. When we're specifically talking about the toes or the foot region, one is going to be extension of toes or the interphalangeal digit or joints of 2 through 5. What is the other action that the lumbricals and interossei share in common? Is it abduction of the first digit, adduction of digits 2 through 5, flexion of the MP joints 2 through 5, flexion of the toes, or extension of the MP joints 2 through 5. So we know that we're not looking, we shouldn't really be looking so much at the interphalangeal joints, because right here it is telling us that we know that these share extension of the interphalangeal joints of 2 through 5, so flexion is not going to be the answer here. They're not going to be antagonistic to each other. Abduction of the first digit, we don't need to worry about first digit when we're talking about lumbricals and interossei. We have other muscles that are going to play a role there. When we look over here, we know that the plantar are going to adduct digits 2 through 5, but the lumbricals don't also do that, so that is not a shared action. And so that leaves these two. So we're focused on those metatarsophalangeal joints, or the MP joints. And do they flex or do they extend? Well, they do not extend. They will flex the MP joints. And that has a lot to do with their placement in terms of where they're going to cross that joint. They will flex the MP joints, but extend the IP joints due to the attachments on the extensor expansions. All right, that is it. Congratulations for making it through the musculoskeletal component of the lectures as well as the laboratories. You've done an amazing job. You've learned ever so much. I know sometimes it can seem a bit overwhelming, but as we kind of review this material and continually review it and ask questions often and early, that will be the keys to success for this portion of the course. As always, please feel free to reach out to me with any questions, and I thank you for your time and attention throughout the course, and I hope you have an amazing rest of your day.